Okay. It should be fine now. Hi, everyone. Welcome to a live reaction of Car 5 Vanguard Will Dress Season 2. For the people who want to watch me when I go live on stream, you can head over to twitch.tv/ggmrrogers whenever I go live. So thank you. Thank you so much for all your support, all your dedication. We're back, baby. We're taking a look at it. welcome. I don't know what that was about, but we're here. Wait, somebody's in awe right now. Oh? Did Urara turn heel? That's a lyrical player. That icon looks like Aichi's hair? Possibly. Is that Zaku's? Man, I hope like a lot of people. She says, screw now. Do you want power? Hi, Kuma Tank. Welcome, buddy. Welcome, welcome, welcome. After the stream, I'll be heading into our Discord and chatting and playing some remote fights. So if people wanna dust off their knuckles, I am ready to battle. I will change the future with a fight, no? Man, look mad! I'm sorry I couldn't fulfill my promise. What was the promise then? Oh, nice. I'm sorry. Deluxe USA. They're currently in America now. Is someone gonna die? We haven't had a death since Ryuzu. Did his epic self-emulation after reading the Bible? I mean, reading the Bible does that to you. It's an exhibition, so it doesn't really matter right now? Okay. I can't believe we got 3 weeks later in Vanguard. Why everything looked like it's shot in Mexico? It looks so clean in comparison to what I see on like street cams and stuff. This looks so much more clean. Not in a bad thing, because of course USA can be a clean place. I'm just saying. I'm just saying. In comparison to what I see on street cams, it looks a lot cleaner. No, man, everything is brown. On our end? Oh, well, yeah, sorry because copyright issues. I'm trying to avoid all of that. Everything is accurate on our end, bruh. Card shop, of course. Oh, look at his smile. I like his beard. Man has a solid beard. I trust him. I trust him with taking care of my dog, if I had one. Looks like a good dude. Bro, they clapping us with DMC. A Baron Magnus player playing against a Hexorb player. Why y'all teasing us with Hexorb? Are they basically the filler character? Like, oh my god, okay, so we have to have like a deck facing against another deck. What are we gonna use? Baron Magnus and Hexorb. Y'all actually just teasing us right now, man. That's actually just not cool. And coincidentally, all of them can speak Japanese. Poggies. Their background decks? I mean, they are, but I want them to be main, bro. How's the episode, Matthew? We literally just started, bro. Sorry for late come. Nah, it's fine. You good. USA known for being multilingual? I mean, Are they though? Glad to catch an episode. Same with Malaysia. But the thing is, Malaysia is kind of forced to learn to speak English, right? And a bit of Japanese, maybe some German or French. Yeah, that was like 2 or 3 years ago he left them. Man, that's crazy. You've still fiending for this dude after months of not seeing him? Jesus Christ, he really gave you a good time, didn't he? That is not how I meant to phrase that. That I did not mean to phrase it that way. Okay, so let me gush for a second. And they got proportions right, the physical contour right, they got lips correct. It doesn't always have to be like over aesthetic wise. The voice is a little soft, I feel, but I mean, obviously we know who's doing the JP voice. Hopefully when they do the English side, that they give him like a very strong voice, strong southern voice maybe. Really good though. People, when they walk away from different fight stream, and he rated you to Mr. Rogers. What do you mean? Oh, you won't die, aren't you? But I bet Chadson is gonna be completely built different and stop the truck with his hand, no? Oh. I do declare. I do declare, sir. Oh my God, sir! Do not vest my, do not reach for my garments that way. Is this the chillest neighbor around? Hi, Radian. How you doing, homie? Welcome, welcome, welcome. Samuel Fredson, da. Sam, to yonde kure. Ore mo kaijou ni mukau tokoro datta nda. Yokatta ra issho ni ikanai ka? Yoroshiku onegai shimasu. Good to see you, buddy. Don't talk to strangers. Me, he's not a stranger. Ariake to nita funiki de anshin shimashita. Kore nara kinchou shinai desu. Yuu janai ka. Peach Mountain. Taisen wa kuji de kimatta nda. Zannen nagara aite wa ore janai. Kyou wa jikkuri misete morao. It looks like he got dreads too. That's solid. Hai, ganbarimasu. I mean, I don't like the fact that it defaulted to dreads, but that's still good. I don't mind it. Kaijou o moriageru o tetsudai o sasete itadakimasu node. Moriageru o tetsudai. Oh, use an MC. Yeah, he's the MC. Sheesh! Matt actually got some real high energy though. Solid. This is supposed to be a Madison Square Garden, but it can't use the proper name because of copyright. I mean, fair. You know what this kind of reminds me? He's just like Tamari. Yeah, he is. But you know what this also reminds me of? If anybody's ever watched any of League tournaments when it's been held in Korea, and like there's the MC that comes on with glasses and stuff, he kind of looks just like him, and he just like goes in, bro. He digs into it. And, like, he just actually goes off. Like, I'll, hopefully future JJ puts up like a small little clip showing you guys what I mean. A man with burning passion. After volcano. Oh, it's Dungey. Peach Mountain is. Oh my god, that name. That name is actually. Don't put fresh. Oh wait, let me take a look here. Let me see if we can identify the cards. Dungey!
Card fight Vanguard. The glitters have obtained great
strength. Name this man after a Faygo drink? Yeah, I thought he was like, yo, Peach Sunday. I was like, oh, okay. So these are the two Ramari Rimaris, and then the grade 2 Upskadid. This is the grade 3 Radia. I personally would have preferred Radia as a grade 1, but, you know, it is what it is. Pink Moth Maple, she's coming out. And then we have Mikani coming out soon. And also two new red lines, plus three new ones. Ish, new-ish ones. Like, I skipped Weishwartz a whole lot, but I do also encourage anybody who wants to get into Weishwartz, play it. It's like a relatively, like, super fun game because you can play with your favorite anime. I mean, go for it, man. Don't let me stop you. Should I trade my Tamariya, my friend's Jejeweled? That's entirely up to you, bro. Doesn't Momoyama translate to Peach Mountain? Wouldn't that be Momotaro? Well, that's Peach Boy, right? Yeah, I know Momo is Peach. But yeah, I guess. Yeah, you're right. I guess so. But I guess you would need to know the translation between, like, English and Japanese of it to know exactly what the translations are. Hey, JJ, wondering, what do you think of the main nation of Dragon Tree gonna be? We don't know yet. I feel it could be Dragon Empire. But it could also be Brand Gate, because it does have like a Link Joker feel to it. Oh! Man said, I'ma fold you, bro! I didn't draw these cards yet, and your life is mine! Richard. Imagine Stoikea, the Dragon of Knowledge. I could see that happen, yeah, sure. Yeah, that could be a thing. Critical! Man up there's old tricks. First check, second check. Guard 15. Stands and draws. He flipped a crit, calm down, bro. Ryu, skill, call trick star. Pretty good. Sheesh! Which he pitched for Ride. Wand pass, heal trigger, Gato. Yep. So you probably give power to the Garantite to make it 20. But still, it's not enough. Woo! Yu goes from 0 to 100 real quick. True. So a lot of people don't like him. A lot of people don't like this, Bruce. Wait. I know what the thumbnail is gonna be. This is the thumbnail, no? That has to be the thumbnail, right? That's where all the budget went? Yeah, it has to. Yeah, that's the money shot right there. The turn quicker than before. Eden gets final rush, plus it restands with a crit too. Stephanie still gets 5k as well, so it becomes 18, 28, 26. And it also restands one of the columns, bro. Shush! Thwack! Wait, Bruce! Homie! What? You're gonna attack with a side column first? Oh. Uh-oh. No trigger. Okay. Damage check? Nothing. Rip every Bruce that can be played. But I'm sure Vehemence is gonna get support, though. It's gonna be fine. We're probably gonna get Bruce cards that has the skill that says... Oh. On hit? But you haven't put out my flame yet. Okay, so this is a hot take. This is gonna be a big hot take here. I don't like the fact that it added old overdress cards into Yeva, but I like the fact that it added them to help older archetypes. This is a hot take. I feel they don't mix that well, but I like the fact that they're trying to force it and they're trying to create different ways of going that route if you so choose to. Like, I respect it. But Jesus Christ, the whole archetype needs 15 counterblast to be able to function. For the love of God, give us some countercharge. Broseph. Like, Valiente needs a counterblast, Barbarina needs a counterblast or soul blast, and Yeva needs another counterblast or two, bro. Like, come on, dude. Like, I see what you're doing, but you gotta give us something to work with, man. Like, I like this. This is cool. This is all cool. And I usually go with the argument, oh, you don't have to use all the CB all the time. It's kind of cool to use some of the CB some of the time. But the only way that Yeva can ever push out pressure is by using all of its CB. It has to. Or else it has no pressure in comparison to the other decks. Like, it has to everything. Can't wait for the order that says the skills on a crossover dress cost 1 CB less. I mean, that would need to be a continuous, though, or something. I see 200 counterblasts and no countercharging. Same, bro. How can Yeva restand a DB301 Farina? I think it just restands a dressed unit, I think. I don't think it can restand the... it just does... The other unit restands itself. The Valiente restands itself. And I think Yeva just restands a crossover dress unit. I think that's how I remember Yeva. Let me go reread it just to make sure. It only just crossover dress? Oh, God. Yeah, it just really restands crossover dress units. But that's kind of the only hot thing for me right now. Oh, that's the order. Yes, I forgot. Okay, I wonder if he's gonna play it now. Okay. I've been trying to chase him, and now I'm catching up. Friendship power. Man said, "Yo, yo, fire! It is nothing." You gotta use a lot of grade 3s in this Yava deck. Like, I still kinda wanna play this deck, to be honest. Like, I really, really wanna play this deck. Cause I have a lot of cards for Verena. I have Arcs. I think I have some Valientes. And I have some Hesperidias. Like, I have some of the cards for this deck, but I'm like, bro, I wanna... Oh my god, that's angry as hell! Man said, I ain't guarding, bro. Stephanie, be gone, woman. I would probably would have gotten rid of like Leonard or Eden here. That is a two to pass. First check. He's playing old Verena, bro. Jesus Christ. Valiente gets 10. For sure, for sure. I ain't guarding, bro. Discard a card and hit. Man just hitting for 28. That's easy. Yeah. Guard with two Trishes. So they're 33k. And Bram. And no guard that one. It's not enough, homie. Lukewarm, bro. It's only Soul Blast card. Yeah. Or Jivarina. No, I get it. I get it. I get like why they run it. It's just sort of like. Damn, that's so tough. Oh my god. Ah. I think he should have retired the Interceptors. I don't think he should have cared too much about Stephanie's. Man just walked up! My god! Wait! Oh my god, that's so sick! Look at the art lines! Look at the lines! This man rolled up into his grill, dude! That's some Josuke Hishigata in there, though. That's some Josuke Hishigata, straight up. For some people who don't know, he played part 4 JoJo, so... Oh my god, the art lines in this look so sick! Now kiss. But no, but like, Yuyu is giving back some too! And that's what I said. I said early no spoilers, but it's animation, man. Yeah, I know. But the thing is, like, Yuyu's giving back something. He's like, yo, get off my grill, bro. Get on my face, bro. Get on my face, bro. Get Bro, step off. Dude, step off. I'm warning you again, dude. Don't make me OT you. Don't make me OT you right now. Danji about to summon a stand. What'd you say about my haircut? What'd you say about my little sister? And now you're paid for it. He's like, Soul Charge. Call Eden. Oh god, that's disgusting. Calling Trish. Get ready for a beating. Okay, so final burst unit gets additional skills and additional effects when you go past the final rush. Let's go, P. Skill Ash, though. Yeah, you're gonna get crit to death, homie. Critical! Second check, crit. Ah! He got God! Damage. Check. Ah, you can get folded like an omelet. Didn't you have more to guard with though, bro? Wait, he didn't have enough? Didn't you heal or draw trigger last turn? I guess he could have intercepted, no? No, he couldn't intercept. There was two grade 3s on a board. He didn't have enough. Yeah, he quite literally didn't have enough. Wow, that's crazy. He discarded for Valiente as well. True, so he literally didn't have enough. Wow. The discard murdered him. Fake Solemn, you always loses with Valiente. Not wrong. Not wrong, sadly. Like, I prefer Esperidia, but I can understand why Valiente is so dangerous, though. Like, it can reset on itself. It's basically a descendant, but it's an on-hit descendant. I would have preferred it being, like, a non-hit. Like, exactly like descendant, though, but that's just me. Just let it go, fam. Cut it from the deck. Weirdly enough, I got a defective nod to deck out Bruce Tempo deck. But it's one of the reasons why I prefer grade 3 Bruce over grade 4 Bruce, though. She's the champion! Oh! Progression? I do declare. Gender diversity. I hate how Yuyu basically has a copy of each Varina in the deck. The glitters have obtained great strength in response to each of their feelings. These heroes are back. This second season is almost the same like what Ryuzu did with the G series. I mean, It's fine. If only if people know about it, they'll know. Alright, let's hear this outro though. Hopefully it's a bop. This end kinda reminds me of Fate Zero. Fate Zero with a bit of Kamen Rider in there. That he used real world segments with some animation stuff in it. Oh Jesus Christ, I was not ready for that. Oh my god, I wasn't ready for like real Dungey for a second. Jesus Christ! Oh, Zorga, yo! Animation looking kinda clean with that one, not gonna lie. Meteors, CEO. Real Danger can't hurt me, but he's gonna drive OT in me, man. Oh god, that's bad phrasing again. I don't know what's wrong with me today. I have some really poor phrasing. Like, oh god. I like the use of the piano here. Yo, you don't toss that card! That's been like a $20 card you just tossed to the camera, bro. Go pick it up. The hell is wrong with you? Money don't grow on trees. Oh, so this is the reason why it was revealed. Okay, fair. Because, I mean, people would see the episode anyway and it's already revealed, I guess. And more passion. Calm down, dude. Is that where they're staying? I look so ratchet, bro. God, you live like this, dude? Which of the stars guys? I wonder if they're playing Minerva. That'd be kind of scary if they're playing Minerva. It's fine, it was his Valiente. True. So my takeaways from this episode. Pretty clean episode. I had a lot of fun with it. I think some of my favorite segments were like some of the artsy parts. The artsy fartsy parts. Like the aggressive part. Like he rolled up. Man just rolled up on you. He said, yo, bro, you actually scared me just now. I'ma fold you. I'ma take your chicken nuggies. You absolutely... Man absolutely just rolled up and said, like, yo, bro, you actually scared me like that. I'ma actually... Now they play the new Dark Souls Demon Witch. Oh, the Succubi, right? Oh, true. The new witches. True. I forgot that. I forgot they were even coming out. Are they going to be part of the Dark Tree faction? Possibly. Kiss him. No. But clean episode. I really liked it overall, though. How many more times are you going to lose because of Valiente discard one? I don't know. Until he learns and registers in his brain that he shouldn't. But this also is a cool thing about this as well. Is that... a very cool thing about this is that they could probably introduce new regular overdress cards again. Rather than just crossover dress stuff. Or you can have a card that says you can treat me as an overdress or crossover dress card in any of the future sets. So you can choose to have it that way. So you can have it choose to fuse with a prayer dragon or have it be by itself. So then the order that you're playing, you can then use both of the skills and both of the sides. Twist both overdress and crossover dress in one unit. Yeah, but that's what I mean. Yeah, exactly that. That it can be counted as both types. Alter ending. Danji. What? Kisses you? Andres. Deluxe dress or something. It depends on what the premise is of this one. a united dress. Uni dress. Aye, aye. I'm here for it, though. I'm very, very ecstatic. Too much sacrifice for Valiente, though. Maybe, maybe. JJ, am I looking back at the outro? You want to see all this arts? Oh, you mean all the pieces and segments they chose? Sure. They chose some, like, a collage motif. Very collage-like. A lot of separate scenes that they did, like, a chroma layer. And they used that to put, a lot of collage pieces with art and stuff. And I think they did, like, oil painting. I mean, most of it is, like, CGI done anyway. Or, not computer generated. But most of it is probably done, like, via Photoshop and stuff. Or via, what's the other program? What's the other art program again? I forget what it's called. GIMP? Yeah, some very, like sketch. Let's sketch-like artwork with a little bit of CGI layered into it. With some of their skills and effects. That's part of the overview and overcast here. And most of them are kind of here downtrodden. And looks like they're getting back up again. You know, trying their best, doing their thing. See, look at that. Some oil paintings. Some more jump cuts to different scenes and segments and characters. Character profiles. What's a tentacle unit? We don't know yet. That's supposed to be his unit. We don't know what it is yet. I think it's the Dragon Tree unit. We don't know what nation it is yet. We don't know. We don't know anything yet. That's supposed to be the Dragon Tree. In any case, guys, I want to thank you guys for watching here on YouTube with me. Thanks for tuning in and thanks for stopping by. This was a little bit of a bit of a teasy. If you want to watch any of this live, whenever you watch this, it's up on Saturday. I will be posting the link to the episode in the description below. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode. It was super fun to do a live viewing of this one. And that's it for the YouTube. Be awesome, stay awesome. Have a wonderful day. Thank you all for tuning in and stopping on by. And take care. In other words, I love you. In other words, I love you.